Hi, I'm Xinyuan, graduating mechanical engineer. I was the mechanical design lead for Bumblebee AEV 4.0, in charge of the overall hardware system design and worked on a metal 3D printed battery house.
My name is Chan Wai, and I'm the mechanical co-lead for Team Bumblebee 2021. I spearhead the team's mechanical development and assist in the testing and improvement of our full range of vehicles to ensure seamless co-deployment.
Hi, my name is Delvin, and I am a senior student studying mechanical engineering in the National University of Singapore. I am also co-leading the mechanical sub-team for Team Bumblebee 2021, and I guide the development of the vehicles to ensure that they are mechanically capable of performing the various competition tasks.
Hi, I'm Hashir. I'm a senior at the National University of Singapore studying computer engineering. I am the current team lead for Bumblebee Autonomous Systems, and I help to develop software to aid in sensor optimization for this year's RoboSub.
Hi, I'm Sean. I'm a senior at NUS studying computer science, and I work on computer vision in Bumblebee's software team.
Hi, I'm Yongte from Bumblebee. I'm a senior studying electrical engineering at NUS. I'm working on the acoustic subsystem of the vehicle.
Hi, my name is Kathy Gian. I'm a year 2 computer engineer, and I'm working on sensors.
For the 2021 RoboSub competition, we plan to deploy both our AUV 4.0 and AUV 3.99. The BB AUV 3.99 was entered in RoboSub 2019 and is currently a stable platform. The BB AUV 4.0 is a ground-up redesign of the mechanical and electrical system, featuring a smaller rectangular hull with integrated electrical components. Its hull design is optimized for space and weight, eliminating the weight penalty incurred by the AUV 3.99 and allowing it to maneuver around tasks with space constraints.
BBAUV 4.0 features highly sophisticated sensors that are optimized to deliver the best possible performance. We have designed our hull and the placement of our sensors for maximum accessibility during testing and debugging, and have ensured that their performances are not affected by other components. Our vision system relies on sonar camera sensor fusion, which increases the reliability of our measurements, while the hydrophones are used for both the pinger task as well as for inter-vehicular communication.
In the design and development of our new autonomous underwater vehicle, we took a vastly different approach to that which governed our previous vehicle, BBAV 3.99. Through multiple rounds of iterations and modifications, BBAUV 3.99 had begun to get heavier and larger over the years. This took away from the speed and agility that the AUV could achieve. We sat back down at the drawing board and sought to design a streamlined, competition-focused vehicle without excess. Our new vehicle, creatively dubbed BBAUV 4.0, was the result of this two-year-long effort to improve and to stay lean. The main hull of the BBAUV 4.0, which was CNC machined from aluminium, houses all the electrical components. Its rectangular design emphasizes efficiency and compactness, allowing for much better utilization of its internal volume in mounting rectangular circuit boards. Through the use of performance analysis tools, such as finite element analysis, the design was further able to be optimized, featuring internal lattices, which allowed for much thinner walls while retaining structural rigidity and a full sensor suite and a host of other capabilities. Cooling of the SDC was done through the use of thermal adhesive and to thermally bond the SDC as well as our embedded GPU to the machine hull, allowing it to act as a heat sink, dissipating heat to the much cooler surrounding water. This design allowed for no additional cooling hardware while fully utilizing the design of the hull as well as the operating environment.
We pushed the limit further of reducing BBAUV 4.0's weight by experimenting with metal 3D printing. The vehicle's battery house were designed with internal lattices within the walls and an isogrid pattern for the base, and this maximized the rigidity to weight ratio as compared to other manufacturing methods. Although there were initial struggles in waterproofing the hull due to its rough and uneven texture, through subsequent iterations and surface finishing, the hull was successful and achieved a depth rating of up to 35 meters. The battery house also directly connected to the main hull using a subcon connector and are supported by crossbars with pins that can be removed with ease. The direct connection minimizes any excess wires, and this helped to reduce the overall weight of the vehicle. Being compact and lightweight, the BBAUV 4.0 is well suited in completing the tasks that require more maneuverability, such as rotating swiftly in the With Moxie task and gaining style points in the Choose Your Side task. This vehicle will also be used for the Cache or Smash task, given its small size to pick up the objects and surface within the octagon. The BBAUV 4.0 will hence be deployed first to quickly complete the With Moxie task and move away from the dock before the slower moving BBAUV 3.99 gets deployed. To further support our competition strategy, we came up with different features that will give us an edge during the competition. The main hull of the AUV contains buttons for starting and stopping the mission, as well as resetting the vehicle at any point of time. The buttons allow us to communicate with the vehicle without having to spend time setting up the data cables, giving us more time to focus on the competition objectives. We also installed waterproof and pressure-tested lights to show the state of the vehicle during the mission, and this helps us to ensure that the vehicle is functioning as intended during its deployment.
Our main HUD was designed with sensor placement and optimization in mind. It features an internal aluminum compartment that separates the electrically noisy components such as the ESCs from the sensors like the IMU and acoustic systems. This allows sensitive components to be protected from any electrical noise from the inductive loads through grounding isolation. This also ensures that our sensors are working with optimum functionality and are able to work adequately so that we can achieve our competition objectives. Our sensors are also mounted such that debugging is as effective as possible. BBAV 4.0 sensor connections, such as those of the cameras, DVL, and IMU, are placed at the lead for easy accessibility, therefore reducing the time needed for debugging. This ensures that our pull tests are conducted with efficiency, which is crucial during the lockdown period where access to the pool is limited.
We plan to deploy both our BBAV 3.99 and our BBAV 4.0 to complete the competition tasks. To facilitate this dual vehicle strategy, an inter-vehicle communication system is required. However, each AUV also requires its own pinger localization system to attend the pinger tasks. As such, we have integrated both the pinger localization and the inter-vehicle communication functionalities into one unified Hydrophone hardware. This is made possible by the dual transmit and receive capabilities of our Hydrophones. This ensures that both functionalities are utilized fully while conserving space as additional sensors and boards are not required, allowing us to reduce the size of our AUV to gain more points during the competition.
Our sensor system adopts a multi-sensory approach for tracking and localizing objects of interest by fusing the data obtained from the camera and front-looking sonar. The sonar is used to identify the range and azimuth to the identified objects, while the elevation is determined by forward projecting the search space and matching detections from the sonar to the front camera. Such an approach produces reliable measurements, which gives us a high confidence rating for the buoy and torpedo tasks.
During the brainstorming phase, we came up with multiple ideas for our new AUV's main hull. One of them was to manufacture individually milled walls, joined at the ends by fasteners and sealant. However, this design required manual application of sealant, which introduced human error as a possible factor of failure. Another idea was to incorporate a large window with an X reinforcement or similar bracing to support the acrylic display panel. Although this panel still allowed for us to have a look at the status display inside the AUV, we realized that the bracing would block a significant portion of the display. Furthermore, from FAA analysis, we found out that this design was susceptible to failure from internal pressure when the hull was pressurized. Mimicking the design cues taken from our metal 3D printed battery hulls, we explored the use of an iso grid to reinforce the flat hull walls, allowing for a reduction of wall thickness and hence a reduction in the overall weight of the hull. Despite the benefits that this design offered us, we soon came to realize that milling iso grids required numerous interrupt cuts, which increases the machining time, leading to an overall higher fabrication cost. The complexity and size of the main hull also meant that metal 3D printing would not be feasible. We decided to simplify the design, opting for a more conventional system of internal ribs to allow for the hull to be milled in one piece. Instead of immediately sending our finalized design for CNC fabrication, we decided to prototype our main hull using 3D printing. This allowed us to obtain a scale model of our main hull within a short period of time, with minimum cost incurred. This model allowed for us to test fit the cables and connectors and figure out any underlying issues with the hull design. Once the model was determined to be accurate and suitable for our usage, we sent our design for aluminium CNC milling. To ensure reliability of the AUV's hulls, BBAUV 4.0 was pressure tested at 3 bars of pressure in a pressure testing tank. This ensured that the vehicle maintained its original design goal and ensured the reliability and longevity of the O-ring seals. A hydrodynamic model of BBAUV 4.0 was generated from numerous CFD simulations conducted, aiding in not only the optimization of the design, but the tuning of the PID controller as well. This was done to ameliorate COVID restrictions, with simulations as well as the resultant hydrodynamic models yielded from CFD analysis being used to allow for near replication of real-world conditions to allow for continued controller testing and tuning.
Despite the limited pool time available during the COVID-19 restrictions, we managed to secure some slots with our school pool for testing of our vehicles. We compensate for the reduced pool availability by coming up with a more efficient overall vehicle design. The top cap of the AUV contains an internally removable sonar connector, which allows for quick and easy debugging when we are testing the vehicle at the pool. Another feature that we added is the quick disconnect pressure connector, which enables us to quickly respond to any drops in internal pressure during our pool test. Our LCD screen, which displays important variables such as hull pressure and battery voltage, is easily removable, which allows us to fix any technical issues immediately and proceed with the pool test. Our batteries are switched on and off using a magnet, and this allows us to hot swap the batteries more efficiently. The PCBs within the main hull were designed such that it was easy and quick to slot in or pull out from the mounts, thereby reducing the time taken to debug any problems. To fine-tune the buoyancy of the vehicle, we designed a customized float that can be attached on top of the AUV, depending on our needs during the software test.
During bench testing of the BBAUV 4.0, the IMU magnetometer readings were found to be inaccurate due to the magnetic field generated by the water cooling pump's DC motor. After various failed attempts at resolving the problem, such as encasing the motor within a steel box, it was decided for the liquid cooling system to be removed from the AUV. The components are closely packed within the main hull, and hence any magnetic noise generated within the hull will significantly affect the IMU.
This was the reason why we abandoned the liquid cooling and switched to the direct cooling method mentioned earlier.
To evaluate this cooling solution for the AUV, a 1-hour stress test was conducted on the Jetson Xavier and SBC to observe their maximum temperatures reached. The results were positive, with both GPU and SBC not exceeding 68 degrees Celsius and were well below the recommended maximum temperature of 80 degrees Celsius for the required processing speed.
To support continuous development of the AUV during the COVID-19 pandemic, a simulator was developed based on the UUV simulator, a package that contains Gazebo plugins and ROS nodes for simulating physics and sensors of autonomous underwater vehicles. The simulation allows the sensors to be quickly tested in a virtual environment for logical and architectural issues, speeding up processes by tightening the feedback loop between writing and testing code, in turn decreasing turnover times for more agile software development. We have also added task obstacles to the simulator this year, which allows us to prototype our task-specific logic quickly and effectively for our mission planner.
Due to the COVID-19 restrictions, most of the testing for acoustics modem was done in a tank in our lab. Basic functionality was tested initially via loopback testing, and in-water performance was tested in the tank. By testing different frequencies, we managed to select the carrier frequency that achieves the maximum range. Following that, a compromise between the data rate, error checking, and packet loss is found via testing. However, as we are testing in a tank rather than in a pool, the multipath effect faced by the modem is significantly higher. In order to mitigate the overlap between the pings, we opted to include guard intervals to ensure that signal received from the previous message and current data do not overlap. Due to the low transmission sensitivity, the signal at the receiver is low relative to the noise. In order to ensure a high enough signal-to-noise ratio for a successful demodulation, we decided to include an additional bandpass filter in the receiving channel.